Hello guys, my name is Crew and welcome back to another episode of CrewCraft. I am going to be using my horse today. I haven't used this guy, I don't think, at all. I think this is the first time I'm actually going to be using this horse. But yeah, this horse is pretty awesome. I got pretty lucky with finding him, because if we don't fail... we failed again, come on. Alright, let's try this. Let's get a running start. Nope. Running start. He can make this jump, trust me. No, I'm jumping too late. Oh man, this is embarrassing. Let's try earlier, right here. Yeah, there we go. He can jump 5 blocks. It's written on here somewhere. It's like 5.125 exactly. That's how many blocks he can jump. He is a good jumper. The best jump is 5.5 and the worst is like less than 2. So, this guy's pretty good at jumping. Yeah, he can make it up here. That's insane. Look how high that is. That's crazy. But today we are going to be working on getting some ice. We got to fill in this entire lake with ice. We got a lot to do. And yeah, that's a lot of ice. We got to also put some ice around here, you know, kind of as this river thing. And then we're going to connect it up to the waterfall that Drew built. And it's kind of going to, the water is going to lead in here, and we got kind of like this pool thing, river, that's going around the tree, and then I think it actually leaves out here to this river, which was here before. So that'll look really nice. We can have a bunch of bridges going above it and a bunch of pathways. That's what we're going to be working on today. Today's going to be make spawn pretty day, because we've been working on this tree a lot the past couple episodes. It's finally done, so let's go the entire way. And let's make the whole spawn pretty. So let's make pathways connect and everything. You know, we gotta connect. Gotta connect all the farms. Connect all the vending machines. Connect all the shops. Even connect this guy. That's Thomas's little pumpkin farm over there. So let's go ahead. And I'm gonna go ahead and run to our ice cube farm area on my horse, and so we can get started building it. Alright, it's almost nighttime, so we gotta hurry up, but this isn't that far away from spawn. You know, spawn's right there, and a cool thing that they changed in the 1.8 update is that on top of extreme hill biomes, you know, you just have to go up a little bit, there's actually a little layer of snow where ice melts, and it's snow, so I actually don't have any ice on me, or any water, but if we place water here, it should turn to ice eventually. We might want to test it before we build an entire farm here. That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to go ahead and test it, and then we'll get ahead building this farm. I don't think I'm going to show you guys building this farm, because it's just going to, I'm just basically going to be following a tutorial of someone, and hopefully it'll turn out great, and we can, you know, get a bunch of ice from it and do stuff with that ice. But yeah, we really need ice on the server, because ice is the way to go. If you guys play Minecraft and you don't use ice, you're doing it wrong, because buckets are so for noobs, you know? But when you have ice, that's like having 64 buckets in your inventory. It's awesome, and it's definitely going to help us make this river. So let's go ahead and get started on this ice farm, and I'll see you guys in a second. Ah, yeah, get messed up, creeper. Alright guys, so I've been working on our farm, and oh my gosh, the assassin games, what is this? Check this out guys. No, I don't want to spoil it. I've gotten some assassin kills, and I'm gonna roll that clip. I recorded some of them. I have to warn you guys though, my microphone wasn't plugged in, my good microphone wasn't plugged in. I had, Thomas did something. But check this out, colored names now. So I added color names, and the players' names are respective to their beacon color. Ooh, jungle temple. Awesome. But so you can see my beacon color here for the assassin games is yellow. It's actually yellow right now, but my Minecraft name is also yellow, so I'm gonna go ahead and clear that. I'm not wearing any armor right now. I really don't want to. Is my stuff still in here? Good, very, very good. But yeah, I'm feeling evil, guys. I've been killing people left and right in the assassin games. I can't wait. Oh man, that's awesome. The assassin gear is in here. Caleb stole one of the swords. Grr. But yeah, it's been going great. I love this variation to the assassin games. How it's you're supposed to be assassin-y, and that's what happened. You're gonna love the clips. Ah man, I'm talking all weird now. What just happened there? I don't really know. But let me show you guys the progress that I made on this ice farm. It is pretty laggy. I mean, I don't know if it's laggy, but I'm definitely not going to be running it all the time. Is the mob farm running? Is it? Yeah, the mob farm's running. That's why I'm bloody this mob farm. This mob farm's annoying. So annoying. Who keeps turning it on? I never turn it on. Mob farm off. Mobs don't spawn. Somebody keeps leaving it on. I guess that's not bad, because then all the drops go down there. But let me show you this ice farm, because I've been... Why are there chests over here? We got a cleanup spawn, man. That's what I'm planning to do this episode, if we ever get around to it. We're going to be building pathways and stuff. That's why I made this ice farm. So yeah, you guys see the ice farm over there? Ah, snap. Man, there's a ton of ice. Holy cheese it. I don't have my silk touch pick, so we're going to have to come back to harvest that. The boat's starting to get there. They're slowly but surely getting it done. And this ice farm, man, a lot of work. Like, this actually took quite a little bit. I was thinking it was going to be, you know, a little 10-minute project where I was just going to have to, like, place a couple rails and then I'm done. Nope. It was actually a lot of pistons, a lot of rails. This went off of, I forget who it was. It was somebody's design. But it was really simple because it uses minecarts and pistons, and you might be thinking, what? But, oh man, this seems loud. Okay, so this is how it works. The ice is made here, and then a minecart's going underneath on detector rails. You can see it pushes up ice and moves it over. So underneath here, we got a minecart. There's a chest in it, and that's just so it goes faster, you know? But there's a minecart down here that's going back and forth, and it's stepping on all these detector rails. Now, these detector rails push the piston, so as it goes back and forth, you can see the pistons are pushing up, and the pistons are going to push up the ice like that until it forms a giant cube. And for some reason, I have no idea why, these two ice blocks aren't freezing at all. I don't know why. It's, like, very frustrating. Like, why aren't they freezing? And neither are these three guys. They're just not freezing. I don't know why. Like, it's an ice biome over here. I think it is. It should be. That's weird. I don't know, but it's been running for quite a while now, actually. And I was thinking it was going to get me more ice, but I guess it'll fill up slowly over time. It should. And, hopefully we'll get enough ice. This should be enough ice, at least for the project that we're doing today, which is filling in the lakes over there. So definitely tons of ice. It's gonna fill up a giant cube, and it's going pretty fast, I think. I mean, I just said it was going slow. Can't make up my mind here. But this took a lot of iron. I think it was like four stacks of iron in total, which is a bit ridiculous for an ice farm. But yeah, a lot of pistons, a lot of rails. These guys had to push sideways. These guys pushing up. These guys pushing sideways. There's a guy in here. So they freeze, then they push up, then they push over, and then they push up again. And then once it gets to 12 blocks, I think that's how high a piston can push, then it just stops until it gets pushed over one more. And it's all Gucci. So yeah, that's our ice farm. Now, let me roll the clips of the assassin game.
Caleb is the only one who has fallen victim to this game.
He's fallen victim twice.
No, nope.
I killed Drew him once.
Drew owes me a diamond.
Oh, you killed Drew?
He tried to kill me, and then I killed him.
Oh, put it in the log. Still, I would say, say Drew failed to assassinate.
Drew sucks.
Say Drew failed to assassinate Nick.
I had all my diamond gear, and then he just tried to kill me, and I'm like, really?
You know what I need to do? I need to like hide a chest No, listen, what?
All the minecart chests are just minecarts.
Yeah. But I need to hide a chest like next to the assassin game with like a bunch of evil potions in it.
Evil potions. Well, poison when and I harming. Make, when I make my potion shop.
I got him. That was pretty lame.
That wasn't really a GG, but okay.
Wait, Jig, what the heck? No, why am I going
here?
I want to go to the end, but I'm going here.
He realizes I need to pick up all of his stuff, right?
Jake, levels. I wanted to go to the end, but I'm going to your pathway. I'm going up the tree.
Sorry. That was kind of a mean kill. I guess I should have let him... I don't know. He should have... When he was coming here, he should have looked at his... at the assassin game, you know?
Yeah, man.
Dude, the bow is still yet to take a damage.
Well,
Alright guys, so that was the first clip of me killing Caleb. I know it was kind of a cheap kill, but hey, we're gonna get these diamonds either way. We're gonna win this assassin game. And yeah, so the second clip, unfortunately my microphone didn't record properly. I didn't have it plugged in, so there is no audio. However, my friends, you can still hear them, so they're kind of talking to me, but you can't hear me, so it's a bit weird, but let me just set the scene real quick. I saw it was Elliot's color, went ahead, I brewed some poison potions, and then I asked Elliot to, you know, give me some sponges, and so he was, like, coming over to my house to deliver the sponges, and here's what happened.
All right, I just left another. I sent him back to my house. Almost.
Still these questions.
God damn, you're asking the same question.
Your house? Now. Sir in the Nether. Where are you now?
Oh my god, there's a creeper right outside my door. Shit my pants.
Answer the door.
I'll greet him politely with a smile and a high five. I won't high five him too aggressively, because then he'll blow up. Dude, I kind of want to get a YouTube channel so I can, like, record every time I, like, before I get on. So, like, if you guys prank me, I could, like, have my reaction.
Why would you guys that? See what it. Would you do with that?
I don't know. You guys could see it and then laugh at me for spazzing out, for, like, freaking out.
So you want us to make fun of you?
I don't know. It would be fun.
You get a something counsel. To do.
What? No, like... Never mind. I'm in...
It's not. Never mind.
Fuck. Why is this fucking zombie following me? Like, what the hell are you doing? Oh my god, it's my color! You're a dick. It's my color! I'm gonna get over...
Two kills no. In one day.
I don't have anything. I don't have anything. I'm poisoned. Fuck. I don't have anything. I need a weapon. Shit. Bye, Jake.
Yeah, Jake, you gotta go eat.
Gotta go eat. Don't upset Scarlett Johansson.
What?
Oh, because his mom married Tony Stark. Just did that.
He just laughed.
When I was walking over, I was like, why does he want sponges anyways? I'll give you a diamond. I just don't want to die because I have a bunch of levels. Oh. I was going to make a big dick.
Jake, kill him.
I swear to God, Jake. I swear to God.
Oh my.
I am going to burn down Tom's
head. No, that's not fair.
I'm kidding.
Oh man, those assassin kills though, that was epic. I mean, Elliot totally did not expect that one coming. That's how the assassin games are supposed to play out. He was kind of a turd head, and he battle logged and stuff. Oh, forgot to put my sound back up. But yeah, he was kind of a poopy head. You're not supposed to battle log. I also think there should be a rule that you shouldn't be able to, like what a lot of guys are doing is they'll be, like, running through spawn, and then the assassin, like, runs up and tries to assassinate them. And instead of fighting back, they'll run over and try to clear their color. Like, no, you can't do that. You gotta fight. Fight for your right to party. But also, Thomas fixed his little chicken over here. That's that. Sorry for the kill on Caleb. That was a bit lame as well. Thomas killed him. I don't know why. We were kind of just, it was like an accidental kill, and as he was getting his stuff back, I killed him in the assassin game, so. That was a bit unfair. But the one on Elliot, that was real. For real, for real. So let's go ahead. what do we not want? I guess we'll just throw our slime blocks in here for now, and same thing with our glowstone. So let's go ahead and name these guys. So we gotta name one HXGM, Booyah, and we'll name this other guy Baba Doo Doo Doo, right? Yeah, awesome. And what we're gonna do with these guys is we're gonna frame them in our base. So that way, you know, if anybody sees our base, we'll have a wall somewhere. It'll be a wall, it'll have, like, I think it'll be underneath our base, like, down by our rabbit farm. There'll be a wall, and it'll have, like, some nice golden armor with armor stands and stuff. And then above it will be all my assassin kills. So far, I've had two. If you guys want to see the kill log, Thomas killed Caleb. What is this? Drew failed to kill Nick. I killed Caleb, and then I killed Elliot. And now we'll see the future. It's been fun, though. It's been, that assassin game's fun. I just cleared my name there a second ago, but there's something else I wanted to show you guys before, I have no idea how much longer we have on this episode. We might be running over time here, but I wanted to show you guys this real quick. Here we go. Check this out. This is what we've been working on the past three episodes. Crap, it's not right. Oh, hello, hello, hello. That's the new guy on, oh, no, that's the new guy on the server. Raul. Okay, so we selected our destination now. This is going to be the destination leading to the Mesa biome. Mesa. I've been getting better with that word. Mesa. Mesa, Mesa, Musa. But here we go. We're off. Da, 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 da. We made this. Nick and I used powered rails, and it works now. Oh, man. Oh, man, I'm excited. We're going to jump off the tree. The tree of life. The tree of wisdom. Oh, we're riding around it. Oh man, I'm excited. I'm excited. We're about to fall off. We're about to. Oh, need a few more powered rails here and there. Not quite fast enough. And here we go. Are you guys ready? Oh man, I'm excited. And da, da, da. That was very anticlimactic. There was a stupid. Minecart in the way. It ruined it. It ruined it. Isn't this, this place up here is beautiful, though. I really want to build a house up here. Look at this. Oh, it's beautiful. I love it. I love this place. If we can get, like, leaves drooping out here, maybe we can make a tree dome, and this could be, like, spawn secret house or something. And then you have, like, the railroad going through here, and you can, like, I don't know what we could have up here. Maybe a message board? There's no way getting up here. That's the only problem. Okay, let's hop back in, and we're off. We're off. We're gonna make the jump. We're gonna make the jump. Woo! Psh! Oh, we'll hop into this one, and then it kind of goes through spawn. They want to sleep, man. What are they doing? And it goes off into another portal. And what we're gonna do is the Mesa biome. It's like 2,000 blocks away. So, it's a bit ridiculous, but what we're gonna do is we're going to send the minecart into the nether, and then, you're gonna be sent into the nether, and then when you're in the nether, you're gonna hop on a track in the nether, and there's gonna be a pathway that leads you to the, Mesa biome, and this side needs to be still lit up, and these guys at the bottom here, where is it at, these, like, little posts, they took forever to make. They look great, and I really like how they look now, but it's a struggle to make these guys. It really is. But I think it looks pretty good, you know? So yeah, I think this is going to be all right, that's all I wanted to talk about. Let's go ahead and do something else. Well, guys, I walked into my storage room to find this. What is this? It's a book. And the quest, you have, the quest. Your items have vanished. To reclaim them, you must follow the clues to retrieve them. Clue number 0, not even starting at number 1, dude, what's happening? So they're in a boat with no water, and, I guess we're recording this, dude, let's do this. But, yeah, our stuff's kind of gone. This is the stuff I had on me, I just placed it in the chest. But we're losing a lot of stuff, and our prismarine's gone too, I think. So, we're gonna have to go ahead and try to find them. The first one, it says it's in a boat, which, I'm guessing I have a pretty good idea of where this one is. Okay, well, I think I found it. Is this it? Boom, ba ba doom. What do you say, boy? Clue number 1, in the tree way up high, is where the next clue lies. Alright. Dude, I did one of these trails. I think it was, like, episode... I forget. It was some episode. It was like a rabbit, evil rabbit killer, and I did one of these for Thomas. And so far, I've gotten back twice. I think, yeah, this is the second time. Zombie Slayer did one, and I have no idea who's doing this one. So our next clue is in the tree, and I believe that's over yonder. Oh, you sneaky devil. I've been running around the top of this tree for like ages. I'm like, where in the world is it? I was looking around here, and check this out. Oh, there it is. That was a good hiding spot. Not gonna lie, that was a good one. Took me a little bit. All right, clue number two. On a friend's head is where your clue... All right. Wait, what did that say? On your friend's head is where this clue has you led. Does that make sense? I don't know. Anyway, trying to get the rhymes down. Oh, this is from Thomas. Thomas said he got stuck up here. We'll just steal his minecart. Do you think I can push it and hop in it? Oh, boing. Awesome. So I'm guessing, you stupid chicken. This chicken's dying. It's a baby chicken. How did you get there? Probably from an egg being thrown. But I'm guessing this one's on top of Thomas's head, which is right there. Thomas is the only player so far to feel so humble about himself that he wants to build a head of himself. How am I going to get on top of this guy? I guess snag some dirt. Cool. Yeah, he's the only one who was like, you know what? I love myself so much that I'm just going to build a giant head of myself. Okay, no, Mikey, this isn't for you. Yeah, Thomas found this quite a while ago. Okay, so clue number three, nether below the earth. Wait, nether below, earth in the middle. The end is where... the end is where the close is to this riddle. Nether below earth in the middle. The end is where the close is to this riddle. I have no idea what that means. Does that mean we have to go to the end or the nether? We haven't really built anything in the nether. I guess I'm going to... I'm gonna check around the nether hub. I don't know what's happening. So I guess I'm gonna check around the nether hub and maybe find something. Who is it? It's orange. Nobody's on. I'm the only one on right now. Why did I even say that? But I guess I'm gonna go ahead and check around the nether hub or something. And then I guess I'll try the end. Okay, well, we don't really have too much of a nether hub going on here. It's kind of just like emptiness. This is Caleb built this little nether room area. Where is this? This is outside. I don't think there's anything outside though. And there's like on top bit, and then over here is, I have no idea what this is, but up here is the boat. That's the portal to the boat. And I think we have some pathways leading to, this is to Nick's house, this is to Caleb's and Drew's house. Up there is just to like get places around the nether. Yeah, I don't see it in here, so I guess I'm gonna go to the end and hopefully my stuff is there. If not, I'm just never getting my stuff back, you know? Oh man, guys, this is Zombie Slayer's new house. Check it out. Oh man, don't check it out. Oh god. Creepers galore in there. Oh man, does he have a spawner? What was that? Alright, so let's head on into the end. Here we are. This is Thomas is working on the Enderman farm. Don't want to spoil too much, but that's his project over here. He's spent ages making this pathway, and I think it looks great. He also have a nice little quartz around the barrier here. This looks cool. Liking it so far. And then we come up here, and I believe he has a pathway up here as well. He's yet to connect this up with that guy. Oh, somebody's mad at me. Somebody's getting angry. Oh man, I hate that sound. Shut up. Shh. But yeah, this pathway is going to be connecting down here. So that way you can go from the portal up to this portal or to the Enderman farm. You know, whatever. And let's see if my stuff is in the end. What's over here? This is lava. Don't know why this is here. Thomas might have something to do with this. Is this it? For crew only. Oh, here's a book. The finish. The end, or this is the end. Hope you had fun, and hopefully you'll have another time for another one. Awesome, that was fun. I enjoyed that. Maybe next time don't take my stuff. That was I'm gonna have to move this all back now. This is all my junk. This is like my diamondy chest, you know. And this is, I have no idea what that is. Clay, wood, some quartz, prismarine, and nothing. Man, I thought I had more than this. That's all the wood I got? Dang it. I do have a lot of quartz though, that's good. Prismarine's sort of running low, use that to build a lot of things. This is my redstone chest, but I had lots of my redstone on me. So, I guess I'm gonna start moving this back, right? Yeah, unfortunately, this is all we got time for today. Sorry if this episode was a bit short. Ooh, what's this? What are you? What are you doing? Eggs, what? I think that was, I have no idea what this is. This is, Nick was building an Enderman farm and Thomas got mad and so he blew it up. This is the remainder. Oh man, you wouldn't believe the experiences that we've had on this server. It's crazy. So yeah, that's going to be it for this episode. Hope you guys enjoyed. I had fun making this episode. We got a bunch of assassin kills. That was pretty awesome. We didn't really do too much. I said I was going to work on spawn, but we kind of ran out of time because of all these interruptions. Grr. Oh, now I'm getting beat up. Oh no. Ow. Jeez, oh, holy crap. Where are they coming from? Get out of here. Ah, I just want to move my stuff back. Also, I guess I'm going to move my stuff back, and I'll see you guys next episode. Adios.